In this particular video of C#.NET, we are going to cover very important concept of C# as well as of .NET framework, that is the assembly. As assembly is the basic structure or the basic way to create or to modularize the application created in C#.NET. You can also use these assemblies for the deployment and configurational things. Whenever you create an application, it has some DLL and EXE files. These DLL and EXE files are known as the assemblies. All DLL and EXE files are actually not assemblies, but any DLL or EXE, if it is an assembly, it will also contain some of the informations like assembly manifest, which we will cover later in this video. In earlier programming, when we used to create the multiple versions of the same application or module, that was a big problem as we were unable to store the multiple versions of the same assembly. That is what we call the DLL help problem. So in assemblies, we will also troubleshoot these DLL help problem and we will be able to create the multiple versions of the same assemblies. Practically, you can classify the assemblies in the private and shared assembly. Let's discuss them separately. Like in private assembly, if you are creating a very simple application, so you can make them as private assembly so that whenever you will be referencing a particular assembly, that is a DLL file, it will not affect any other application. In the private assembly, by the time you add the reference, one copy of that DLL or that assembly file will be there in your own project. So it will definitely take the or increase the size of your application. But it will not affect another application at all as you have your separate copy for this application. And as I said, we can use it for the simple application. So the management like registration or versioning so on is not required. But if you want to share the particular assembly for the multiple applications, we can go for the shared assembly. To make any assembly shared, first of all, we will have to make some changes in the current assembly, that is in a private assembly, such as we will have to assign a strong name through the SNK file. We will have to put some versioning thing, and later we will have to install that assembly in the global assembly cache, in short GAC. Once you install the assembly in the global assembly cache, you will be able to take the reference of that assembly, and by the time you will be taking the reference for a shared assembly, the local copy will not be generated like the private assembly. So this is what the difference between a private and shared assembly is. Now let's find out the structure of a particular assembly. Like each assembly contains the MSIL code, as after the first stage of compilation, when your C# or VB or any language code got compiled with the specific language compiler, we get the MSIL code. So that MSIL code will be stored in any assembly in form of DLL or EXE. Apart from that, Windows header, CLR header, metadata, assembly manifest and resources will all be there inside the assembly. Let's discuss them separately. As MSIL code, as I said earlier, it is the compiled code from any specific language compiler. The machine will not be able to understand that. It requires some just-in-time compiler in order to execute this code. Next is your Windows header. Windows header basically first of all checks the Windows, like how this particular window will load or manipulate a particular assembly. Along with that, it will also judge like which particular type of application you're working on, whether it's a console application, Windows application, or any console or any class library. It will all be taken care of by this Windows header. Apart from that, we also have a CLR header, which is a block of data that all .NET assembly must support in order to be hosted on CLR. So it will definitely check the compatibility of each assembly with the CLR. Metadata. Metadata simply means the data about the data or the information about the information. So describes the format of contained types as well as the format of external references. As one assembly may be created of multiple files, so if there is any dependency, it will also store that inside itself. And next is resources. As resources will take care of all the external things such as the picture or audio file or any culture or UI culture information. So this is what each and every assembly, whether it is an EXE or DLL, will contain in itself. Now let's see practically how we can start working with the assemblies. So now let's start with the implementation of assemblies, in which first of all we will take a class library which will give us some public classes which we can use in some other projects. So here we are going to see the two types of assemblies. First one, the class library, will be a DLL, that is dynamic link library, while the second one, in which we will add the reference of that DLL, will be the main application with some EXE type of assemblies. So let's start with the DLL first. So here I'll come to file, new project, and from here, from this dialog box, what I'll do, I will choose one application of class library type. So as you can see, I have taken a class library. Let me name it manage user. Let's say okay, and here you will get a namespace called manage user, inside which you will get a class. This is a public class, as we have discussed earlier in the access specifiers, that public class will be able to be accessed from outside projects as well, which is in some other assemblies. So here I'll change the name here, let's say user, and inside that I will create a couple of public methods. So as you can see, I have created a couple of methods right here, like public string hello user, with it, which will be taking a string parameter, and it will return hello plus that username. Similarly, one is authenticate user, which will check the username and password. I have taken some hard-coded username and password here. So if you will enter the same values, it will return a true, otherwise a false. So this is about this particular code. Now let's build this. And here, as you can see, one succeeded, zero failed. So it is done. If you will come here in the Solution Explorer and we'll check the library here. So this is the location where your project is created. Inside this bin debug, you can find there is a DLL file existing. Because it doesn't have a main method, so there is no entry point, there is no start point, so it will behave like a DLL, that is dynamic link library. That simply means to some other project we can link it, this library, at runtime, that is dynamically. So let's do that now. For doing that, I'm back to my Windows application, where I will take a couple of text boxes for username and password. Let's arrange them here, and a submit button. Alright, so this is about my form which I wanted to design. Now I will have to add the reference of that DLL to this project. Since this is what I call a private assembly, so as I said in the introduction as well, like whenever you will be done with the DLL, which is a private assembly, you will have to add the reference of each DLL in the each project on which you will be working. So let's do it by right clicking on this project name, say add reference, and in this dialog box you can find a lot of DLLs. These are some predefined DLLs, but here I'll come to browse to the location where you have saved it. So this is my project, manage user. Inside this bin debug, I will get that DLL file. So let's add it here. Say OK. And now in this references folder, you can find the manage user as well. So let's double click on this submit button so that we can start coding for that. And before starting with the coding, let's add manage user library. Alright. So inside this manage user library, I'll get a class called user. I will instantiate it here, and now
I'll be able to call the user's method like authenticate user and hello user. So let's see. And now after instantiating this, you can see like if user.authenticate user, where I was asking for the username and password, I have passed the value of the text box 1 as the username and text box 2 as the password. If it is the same value as we have passed in the library, the hard-coded values which we have passed in the libraries, we will be able to show this message like hello user method, which is again there in the library with the same username, else invalid username and password. So as you can see, I have not done any logical code here and I have not specified any value here. It is being done from this external project, that is the manage user. So let's come back to this one and let's see how the output will look like. So if you will enter the same values as you have passed in the library here, password text box is a plain text box so that you can see the value as well. So I'll say submit and you can see hello Anadi, that message is coming from the hello user method. But if I will change anything either in username or password, I will get invalid username password value. Alright, so this is how you can start implementing the private assemblies by adding the reference of each library in each project where you want to utilize that. Now, if you want to make this DLL as the shared assembly, so what you will have to do, first of all, you will have to assign a strong name. So for doing that, let's right click on your project name, come to properties, and here you can find the assembly information. Let's click on this, and here you can see the title, description, company name, product, copyright, all these things are there. Alright, so you can mention the values, otherwise you can also continue with the defaults. As you can see, I have changed some values in description and company name. You can change the product. Now here, in the assembly version, you can actually pass the versioning. As you can see, the version is classified into four different parts. First is major, second is minor, third one is build, and fourth one is revision. This is the default value of any particular assembly, that is 1.0.0.0. But since it is my assembly, I can make it change to any value, like 10.0.0.1, let's say. Now, since this is the first version which I'm creating right here, if I'm going to make some modifications on this project, let's say I want to add a new class or some new functionalities on the same class, so according to the changes, I can also modify the version and I can store multiple versions all there as a shared assembly, which will also allow us to get rid of the DLL hell problem. So on the base of the changes you are doing, you can either make the change on the revision, build, minor, or if it is a very new project or with a lot of changes, you can also change the major version. Like for example, .NET Framework 3.0 and 3.5. So major is same, that is 3. Minor is getting changed from 3.0 to 3.5. Similarly, you can make some major changes as well, like 3.5 framework to 4.0. Now from 4.0 to 4.5, again there is a minor change, and 4.5 to 4.6, 0.1, as you may have heard, the different versions of .NET Framework. So these are all about the type of changes that we are making in the versions. So similarly, you can do it from here as well. Let's say okay. So this is the assembly information which you have changed. After that, for providing the strong name, what you can do, you can come to the signing thing. Just check this checkbox, says sign the assembly, and it will allow us to create the SNK file, that is strong name key file. So since I haven't created yet, so I'll have to create a new file here with the name mykey.snk. I'll not put any password out there. Alright, let's say okay, and you can see here in the solution explorer mykey.snk is there. If you will come to the assembly info.cs as well, you will see all the changes that we have done, like title, description, company, product, copyright, including the version as well. So you can also make the changes right here or doing it from here, like assembly information. And along with that, now I have also put the SNK file. Now, logically, my assembly, my DLL file is ready to be installed out there in the global assembly cache. To do that, let's open the command prompt. For doing that, let's come to the command prompt. Here, you will have to choose developer command prompt for Visual Studio 2015. Because here itself, you will not have to change the path, set the path for the utility which will help us out for installing your assembly to the DLL, to the global assembly cache. Alright, now let's say the command GAC, that is global assembly cache util, and say enter. So you can see this command is working fine. Alright, now let's first of all change the path where I have put my DLL file. So now the path is being changed from the CD command, and inside this you will find the manageUser.dll. So for installing that, first of all you will have to start your command prompt as the administrator. So whenever you open the command prompt, just say open as run as administrator. Like here itself, I'll right click and will say run as administrator, and now we'll paste this. Alright, so this is my DLL name, GAC util global assembly cache utility hyphen I option for installing this particular DLL to the GAC. Let's say enter. Alright, it's showing me error because after adding this strong name key, I haven't rebuilt this. So let's build it again. Alright, so all the changes have been made. Let's run this command again. And now you can see assembly successfully added to cache. Let's see where it's being installed. So here you can come to your C drive, Windows, Microsoft.NET assembly, and inside this you will get the GAC MSIL folder where you can find the same name folder, that is manage user, and when you will open that, you can see the framework version, the version of your assembly and the strong name. So this is your DLL file. If you will make some changes in your existing file and will rebuild this DLL and will install it again, it will also come in here in the same location and will create one more folder with some different version whichever you have passed. So this is how you can start working with the assemblies and can plan whether you want to use a private assembly or a shared assembly.